This video is for helping users install a disk drive. As always, when working inside your computer, turn it off, make sure it's unplugged, and that you're properly grounded to protect your computer from electric static discharge. As can be seen in this picture, the back of the disk drive has four connectors and jumpers. Before inserting the drive into the computer, make sure the jumpers are properly set. If the drive is connected on the same IDE cable as another drive, we suggest the disk drive be set as slave. If the drive is on a cable by itself, set the drive to master. Once the jumpers have been properly set, insert the drive into an available drive bay in your computer, as shown on this video. Once the drive has been inserted, secure it in place by screwing each of the screws into the side of the drive. Next, insert the IDE cable into the ATAPI interface on the drive. This connector is keyed and will only allow the cable to be inserted in one direction. Next, insert the Molex power connector. Like the previous cable, this cable is keyed and will only be able to be inserted in one direction. Once this cable has been put into the drive, your computer should automatically detect and set up the drive upon booting it up. If you're wanting to use this drive to make your own disks, software capable of doing this may need to be installed. If your CD-ROM, DVD, burner, or other disk drive is not working, or you have other questions, feel free to visit computerhope.com.